opinion, although I guess you don't respect mine. Thanks for your call. 718-937-6666. We changed from the big orange ball to the little white ball. Well, not the little white ball, but, you know, the one with the red stitches in it. Michael Jack Schmidt will be with us after the 2020 update. With Vince DeLisi, wherever he is, it's coming up straight ahead. Then there's more of me, Bill Daughtry, with you on the bench. Sports Radio. Sports on WFAN, the flagship station for New York Knicks basketball. Good evening, 704 on the fan. Bill Daughtry at 718-937-6666. As per usual, a stellar performance turned in by Vince DeLisi on the 2020 Sports Update.
Still not getting a ride for that.
That's all right.
You gotta get a raise for that.
You asked for a ride.
No, no, no. As long as the car is functioning, and it got me here.
It did.
It always gets me here.
It's getting home.
That's been a challenge on occasion.
And at 7:35. We'll be back after the ball game, so you keep it right there on 66.
WKQV FM 96.
Right. Here's Mike Pachuta. Is that right?
Great, thanks.
Okay. Going in for Bremen Sports. Good morning, Mike.
Exactly what I'm talking about. The Cujo Imus.
I said, Brant, in those 14 years, how many times did Imus put the partition up? And does he put the partition up with Deirdre? And I'm afraid Brant gave you up.
Yeah, where's Brant?
He's shaking out in the hallway. Get him in here right now.
Your radio sounds funny in the morning. You're listening to Imus in the morning.
You revealed information about me to somebody?
Oh, my God.
Brant, answer me, Brant.
Excuse me, what do you want me to say?
Well, you're not allowed to reveal any information about me, you nitwit.
That's policy. That's funny.
And then I said, well, why does he do that? And Brant said, she's his baby.
Whoa. Literally.
That's what's happening. I'm John Clossy with 2020 Sports on WFAN, the flagship station for New York Knicks basketball.
Hey, good morning, everybody. Russ Fulford with you here down in a very hot and sunny field at Fort Lauderdale, Florida, Yankees training camp on the 25th day of February, 1994. The number for you to call is always 718-937-6666. And I'm telling you, it is the hottest day we've had since being down here. The sun is just baking. And mind you, I'd rather be where I am than when you are. And I guess I'd also rather be...
baseball columnist of the Daily News, John Harper.
Good job. A great job out of Bob Gelb with Mary Lynn Gleberfield. A great job, whatever her name is. Gild Gleiderman, whatever her name was. Did a tremendous job getting her in the studio today. Luda Shepherd, outstanding. I'll be away all next week. Mike will take you from Wednesday on. We got a Daughtry and Iron combo Monday and Tuesday. And Jody Mack tomorrow morning. Enjoy the week off for me. I'm sure you will. And I'll see you March 7th. Have a good one. Adios.
Degrees, and that's what's happening. This is Bob Huesler with 2020 Sports on WFAN, the flagship station of New York Knicks basketball.
On the fan. Good evening, everybody. Iron Eagle taking you until 8:35. The Knicks in Denver tonight, hoping to avoid a third straight loss. It's been pretty tough to deal with the last two games the Knicks have played. Some people are pushing the panic button, others just pushing the button of concern. Either way, this team is not playing up to par, and we'll talk about that a little bit later on at 718-937-6658. We wrap up this first hour. Still another hour and a half to play with until the Knicks and the Denver Nuggets on the fan tonight. Coming up at 7:05, third base coach of the New York Mets, Mike Covich. Spring training well underway. We'll get a report from Port St. Lucie. Later in the hour, JoJo Starbuck, former Olympian. Talk a little bit about Tonya Harding, Nancy Kerrigan with more on that. Everything else going on in sports. Bob Huesler, the update at 7. In the outfield right now, and strangely enough, even though they have a lot of pitchers in camp, I don't know if they think they have a great deal of talent at middle relief. So I don't think they're going to trade any of those guys away right now to get an outfielder. It appears Danny Tartable is here to stay. I think Tartable is going to be a Yankee in 1994. He's got a big salary. Thanks to Sweeney Murdy and Lisa Johnson. Talk to you tomorrow. He will be in the Hall of Fame, and he will also be on PIX doing those Yankee games until the seventh inning, or until lightning or thunder strikes, whichever comes first. 718-937-6666. All you hockey folks out there, get on the line because Pat Verbeek of the Hartford Whalers is going to join us and talk hockey coming up on our next segment on The Fan. You stay with us.
Let me say this about Letterman. He's a genuine guy, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's not a phony. It's good. I had Mary Connolly, my new best friend over at Letterman. I love her.
Right.
She doesn't know this, of course. She's not already done this material 10 times. So she's telling me what she thinks are good punchlines and stuff. She said, well, you know, I really think this would work if you just said there were like a few feathers. I said, really?
Uh-huh.
She's the same one who coached Mike Lubica.
Well, I got if your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning on The Fan.
All right, here live from El Paso now, my brother Fred Imus. Good morning, Fred.
Take the suit back to Kmart. That's where he got this. He got it.
Did you actually see me or not?
Yeah, I did.
Okay. Did you think I'm? Do you think I'm too thin?
You're so late. I thought you were on Pat O'Brien's show.
This is the 50
station for New York Rangers hockey. Speaking of hockey, our hockey correspondent from the Hartford Whalers, Pat Verbeek, joins us now, as he does on a semi-regular basis. Pat, how are you?
Mr. Bradley, you got a good show coming up, Richie, a little baseball. Greg Olson, new Met catchers.
Oh.
Going to join us, Dave T. Thomas, four-man's guide to the NFL, talk a little NFL draft, and Matty Gukas to talk some basketball with us, NBC's analyst.
Excellent. Jody Mack, Richard Neer, I'll be back again Monday night at 6 o'clock. Have a good one.
With me?
Yes.
For hammering Connie Chung. I thought she brutalized this kid and asked her questions that were just designed to show how tough she was.
A lot of times in journalism, it reminds me of that old Van Morrison song, All the Girls Drop Walk By All Dressed Up for Each Other.
I love this rock and roll analysis.
Oh, that's pretty good.
I love this.
Does Deirdre Van Morrison, does she go back to Van Morrison? Or...
Yes.
Okay, just asking.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning on The Fan.
Well, we just let's get Connie on this morning to see if Connie thinks I brutalized her.
She probably ran down the street to Lillehammer like that naked Vietnamese girl that you see the pictures of screaming
with napalm.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, exactly. Well,
Vince DeLeese here at 2020 Sports on WFAN, the flagship station for New York Knicks basketball. Good morning, everybody. Coming up on 5 minutes after 10 here on Sports Radio 66 WFAN. Jody McDonald sitting in for the dog today. We have 5 hours of sports conversation coming up for you. As I just said with Richard, we're going to do a little baseball, a little football, a little basketball, get into hockey as well, whatever it is you want to talk about. Certainly on the telephone lines, Greg Olson, new New York Mets catcher, will join us sometime during the day. Dave T. Thomas, independent scout to the National Football League. Let's take a look. We saw the girl get whacked in practice. We knew she was hurt. So you're going to deny her medicine? There are some tough people out there. Coming up on 11 o'clock here on FAN. Mac Man with you. One in the books, four to play. Vince DeLeese is in. He's got the top of the hour update. On the other side, we'll be joined by Matty Gukas, analyst for NBC. He'll be doing the Suns and Knicks. Coming up tomorrow, we'll talk overall NBA hoops with Matty. We'll also keep it on the phones with you, so you keep it here.
Mike Breen's on the road with the Knicks, so Russ Salzburg is here. You like hockey? I bet you do.
No, you know, not as much as I used to.
You seem like a hockey fan.
Yeah, you do.
So you got to be drunk punching people in the
exactly.
stands.
Right. Like going with my kids to a basketball game. Do you go with your kids to games?
Well, my kids are all, you know, they're gone, so they're all. You know,
how about Gidget?
They hate
they
fled.
They don't want to see him.
How about who?
Gidget.
Shut up. Yeah, well, they're just two sports. Gidget
and the old-timer, yeah.
Shut up.
Gidget and the geezer.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning on The Fan.
People don't need to know anything. about my personal life.
Does she worry when
you two people
do the wild thing?
We don't do the wild thing. We're not married, and it's none of your business anyway. God.
You better not. You'd probably drop dead.
Fine.
In the morning.
WFAN 2020 Sports.
Good afternoon.
Here on Sports Radio 66 WFAN Saturday morning in New York. Jordy McDonald taking you through till 3 o'clock. The Birdman Iron Eagle flies in at that time. Been jumping around talking about a whole bunch of different things during our first hour. Going to get a little bit more specific and talk some hoops in hour number two when we kick it off talking to lead color analyst for the NBA on NBC, Matty Guka.
That's just the way that it's set up right now, and politics happen to be involved probably with Orlando Cepeda as well. When he's eligible to get in via the seniors committee, let's hope that on the first year of that, Orlando Cepeda will be in Cooperstown in addition.
Sports, 28 degrees with the wind, feels like it's 7. And that's what's happening. I'm Paul Olden with 2020 Sports on WFAN, flagship station for New York Rangers hockey.
Fan hour number two is underway. Iron Eagle taking you until 7 o'clock. We'll be followed tonight by ESPN Radio. And then the Rangers in Dallas to take on the Stars. 718-937-6666. We'll have some more phone calls coming up. Covered a lot of topics thus far in the first hour, including baseball. We'll move on and shift our attention to basketball now. Knicks with another loss last night. Nets lose in Orlando. Joining us on the Fan right now. You've got to be within the top three. And Nancy Kerrigan obviously was number one, but Oksana Bayul was number two. She ends up winning the long program of the competition, wins the tiebreak because she took the long program last night in Hamar, Norway. Between the two, I happen to like Bayul's style a little bit more. Kerrigan did a super job, but I can't really quit with a winner.
What's happening? I'm Paul Olden with 2020 Sports on WFAN, the flagship station of New York Knicks basketball.
On the Fan, Iron Eagle with you till 7 o'clock as we continue on this Saturday afternoon in New York. 718-937-6666 coming up after the 2020 Flash. We'll talk to Bert Sugar about Jersey Joe Walcott, a Hall of Famer, oldest man to win the heavyweight championship. He died last night in Camden, New Jersey, 80 years old. We'll talk to Bert Sugar a little bit about Jersey Joe Walcott coming up. Until then, though, they're probably going to have to make another trade. If it's a third baseman, then you move Bonilla back to the outfield, and you start shuffling your lineup all over again. But they're just trying to take advantage of what they have right now. And in doing so, Bonilla at third makes more sense for them offensively. Coming up, more phone calls at 718-937-6666. Iron Eagle taking you until 7 o'clock. Paul Olden has the update at 6. Stay tuned.
Sports Radio.
Sports on WFAN, the flagship station of New York Rangers hockey.
.605 on the Fan. Our final hour is underway on this Saturday in New York. Iron Eagle taking you until 7 o'clock. We'll be followed by ESPN Radio tonight, and then it's the Rangers and the Stars in Dallas, Texas. Pre-game coming up at 8:30. Face-off is set for 9:05, so make sure you stay tuned for that. 718-937-6666. We continue to talk to you on the telephones. Lots of topics out there. Done so.
Radio 66, WFAN.
6:58 on the Fan. night game against the Phoenix Suns. That'll be a nationally televised game tomorrow afternoon. Nets are home for the Dallas Mavericks. No television on that game. Our thanks to Steve Cohen, Lisa Johnson, Lewis Shepard, and Joan Chin today. Don't forget, Monday at 1 o'clock, Bill Daughtry and I will be filling in for Mike and the Mad Dog. It'll be from 1 until 6 p.m. Both of those guys on vacation. Bob Hustler standing by with the update. ESPN Radio after that. So long. Have a good weekend.
As opposed to doing what it takes to win. Good point, Robert, but we'll see. There's no shootout there, and what the heck. I enjoyed it. Just as I enjoyed this afternoon with Stevie Cohen, Doug Kramer, and you. We'll see you tomorrow with the Bird at 1 on the Fan.
Senior political analyst Richard M. Nixon.
A very senior Imus in the morning. I mean, they're going to have to carbon date me on my next birthday, for crying out loud. Oh, well, several matters compel our attention, J.D., so let's not dawdle here. Issue one, and this is unbelievable, Janet's Gone with the Wind Reno. Our crusty attorney general, as she was described recently in the New York Times, causing me to wonder if that was a reference to her underwear or some condition that has affected her mind. Because suddenly, the attorney general of the United States thinks she's Nora Ephron. To counteract violence in TV programming, she started writing pilots. And we wonder why the Times headline on her was Doubts on Reno's Competence Rise. Yeah. The entire country's getting its brains bashed in every 20 minutes, and Reno's solution is to crank out plot treatments for Jeff Sagansky. Oh, great stuff, too. 14-year-old offspring of crack-addicted mom raises siblings while she goes off to rehab, and he graduates from high school class valedictorian. Yeah. Hey, happens every day. I mean, there goes your street crime problem, my man. Yeah. Solved by crusty AG submitting dribble to NYPD Blue. Her other fix for the violence epidemic?
Right.
Show baseball games earlier in the day. Damn, and it was so obvious. I can just see some punk saying, hey, I was going to knock over that liquor store, but hell, the Mariners are playing the Royals, so here, take my gun. Actually, Dono, inspired by the Attorney General, I'm developing a story plot myself. See what you think. 14-year-old heroin-hooked urban cannibal gets treatment for eating disorder, graduates summa cum laude from the Culinary Institute, becomes president of the United States, and fires stupid Attorney General. Jesus, where is Zoe Baird when we need her, huh?
Well.
Issue two. And I hope you take this in the light in which it's offered.
All right.
Stern makes the cover of Time.
Right.
And your big news is you're being picked up in Rochester, New York. Well, that's like the Times endorsing David Dinkins the other day while Rudolph Giuliani was winning that coveted endorsement from the immeasurably influential Crane's New York Business. Oh, well, as you point out, the war's not over, but the battles are killing me.
Yeah.
Anyway, issue three, Haiti, an update. The United Nations has invited, get this now, former President Jimmy Carter to go down there and, well, do what?
Well,
help him build boats? Hand him paddles? Remember what happened the last time Carter got involved with the Caribbean country?
Yeah.
We wound up with 100,000 drug-fried Cuban carjackers waiting ashore at Cocoa Beach. What a great idea. Send Jimmy Carter to fix Haiti. Excuse me, Pablo Pierre, but I don't think so.
Yeah.
Oh, final item, Dono. Now they clone humans, huh?
Well,
just think. If they'd only come up with that a few years earlier, J.D., it strikes me, I maybe could have run again and won again. And this time, burned those f***ing tapes. And that's the world through this Dick's eye, J.D.,
yeah.
That of Dick Nixon, who should still be the president of the United States.
Well.
Damn, I gotta run. See if I can intercept that Peckwood diarrhea. Hey, you want me to get your name out of it?
Well.
Can do, I think.
5 till 7 here in New York. Good old good one from Chicken Dick. Half poison. Little dumb and kick your brain coming up. Doobies now.
We have to take
tell you this one time. You remember, I think it was last year, I was late one time I came in here.
Right.
And you were talking about how you were going to give me a drug test and stuff like that.
It's like, probably the only test you could pass.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning on The Fan.
Highway Patrol.
I'm Imus Simone, and if you're in Sacramento, California.
Out in the West Texas town of El Paso.
Great Imus in the Morning.
Save hundreds in the morning. 2020 sports. All right, here now from Mike Breen, who is on the road with the New York Knickerbockers, from NBC Sports, one of the premier football sports, well, not just football, sports broadcasters in the country,
yeah.
Don Kirky. Good morning, Don.
Good morning, I-Man. Fred was telling me when Grandpa Imus first came to New York, this woman comes up to him on the street and says, Mister, do you want super sex? Grandpa Imus says, I'll take the soup. Enjoy. Moving right along here now. To the... We had the, on the odd occasion, the I-Man would have a cocktail.
Yeah.
He said one time the I-Man was kicked back with a snifter of brandy in front of a roaring fire.
Right.
Then he realized he didn't have a fireplace in that apartment.
Well, I think we need to delve into my past drug and alcohol abuse. You know, I've been sober almost 7 years. Isn't that amazing?
Well, fantastic. Yeah, and you weren't an abuser. On the odd occasion, you were overserved by an unscrupulous bartender.
That's exactly right. People just trying to make a buck.
You were a victim, I-Man.
Okay, so that you can get up to speed on what Rob has done here on this hideous program, this is a group called Saget and a thing called Funked Out. Let's check that a little bit out.
Funked Out.
Funked Out is what he says.
Question. Why is it that every time I'm walking down the street, somebody wants to stop me just to give me a fly? Come on, man. Funk that. Get out of my way.
This is a current hip-hop inversion, not the parody.
Thank you. time I see my neighbor, he tells me how boring Imus is. And they look at me like I'm the one who interviewing Jeff Greenfield at Anna Quigley. Come on, man. Fuck that. What are you listening to?
My hobbies in life, sweat, sex, money, and murder. From your bitch. Money from the crack. Murder is a hobby that I have since way back. This is the way I live. Pain and torture, believing life, sex, money, and
mind. I'm a in the morning.
Hey, here's a revolutionary.
Three with the Islanders. Thomas Johnson.
Ah, he was coming up. And so is Minka with the update.
Mike and the Mad Dog. Sports Radio 66. WFAN.
Billy, it's been a pleasure.
Absolutely.
Thanks to Al McGuire, Marv Albert, Rob Tepper, Daryl Kramer, Ian Eagle, Bill Daughtry. We'll see you again here tomorrow, 1 o'clock, for Mike and the Mad Dog. Richard Neer is next on the fan.
Mike and the Mad Dog, Sports Radio 66,
WFAN. Please, that's what's happening. I'm John Clossy with 2020 Sports on WFAN, the flagship station for New York Rangers hockey.
Richard Neer in for Howie Rose on the fan, Sports Radio 66 WFAN. Howie is, of course, calling the game at Madison Square Garden tonight as the Rangers take on the Philadelphia Flyers in a game that was originally supposed to be played the night that we got that blizzard that Friday night. So they bumped the game over here. Actually, I think it was another game that was supposed to be played then, and they bumped that game, and they had to bump this game as a result. I don't know. Anyway, there's a hockey game tonight. That is
one here, and here's the villain here. Well, our hero, John Clossy, is here. He'll update us on the scores and stories and Mike Lupica and everything else you want to know. And then the Ranger pregame show. We'll be back after the game sometime around 10:30. Stick around on the fan.
This is the...
Around 204, right?
Yeah, I lost 15 pounds, but my cholesterol's still too high.
Yeah, but the other day I read about the Clintonburg and that pastrami sandwich and that apple fritter the size of a baby's head that you're eating.
hey, that's the apple fritter. I had one bite of the apple fritter.
Well, then,
by the way, that's all right. I did get off my diet that day.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning.
A lot of problems in the healthcare system, mostly related to the way we finance it.
One of the ways, Mr. President, you could settle all this is for you and the First Lady to take on Harry and Louise from those insurance company commercials in like a segment of American Gladiators.
Yeah, you know, I wouldn't mind that, actually. I heard about them, I thought they were Thelma and Louise, you know.
Japanese comedian Buddy Miyagi. Good morning, Buddy.
Imus-san. Anata wa nante me hashino kiku metana shiyaku tataru desho.
Well, pardon me?
What a perceptive and amazing host you are.
Right.
You treat all with equal disrespect and contempt.
Yeah.
You have, as we say in Japanese, okinawa kesu ipai no boru, a big basket of balls.
Fine.
Winter Olympics have concluded. Time for the tireless struggle of honorable athletes for exalted profession to move on to next happy challenge. Nagano, in 1998. We promise excitement when winter games come to Japan. Disgraced competitors will be required to perform ritual suicide. Seppuku, you think smacking knee was big deal? If it had been Japanese figure skater who had dishonored competition with Infinity Ice Skate, she would be forced to center of ice to disembowel herself with samurai sword.
That would be fine.
And then she would be judged on her execution of that task. And if she gets less than 5.9 for artistic impression, we make her do it again. We do not tolerate inferior aesthetic endeavor.
Do we have any funny material?
I have big time showbiz material.
Right.
Hoping to get break on the rhythm in the show. Hey, what an inferior crowd. How you doing? Where you from? Hey, did you hear about the American who graduated from a first grade?
No.
He was so excited he could hardly shave. What did Roy Benson say at the G7 meeting?
I don't know.
G7? All I need is N32 and I have bingo. What is Mickey Cantor's answering machine message?
I don't know.
Hello, I am in right now, but you will be unable to speak to me as my phone does not work. Aurora Corporation begin his day? By going back to bed. What is difference between deadbeat fiancé and Motorola cellular phone?
I don't know.
Neither one will give you a ring. I now do impression of blind American pop star Stevie Wonder.
All right.
I cannot go to say I love you. The phone is broken, made by Motorola. Why is Motorola phone like dire of prayer for atheists?
I don't know.
You make call, but nobody answers.
I was in the morning. 2020 sports. Stupid.
Why?
Funny, man, Hardy. Only I'm showing a program.
What?
I'll be occurring frequently.
Boy, I don't know.
Good grief.
Because he can call it?
Yeah, I mean, come on.
Got photo on the phone.
So, Billy Taylor used to be a running back for the New York Giants, and...
Mobile fan highway patrol.
All right, here now, media wants a proctologically intensive inspection of the state of American broadcasting by the dean of broadcast journalists, Walter Cronkite.
Just as prophets of old warned of the end times, this wise old veteran of the fourth estate is running up storm flags of his own today. For with the insidious movement of a rodent spread virus, the Imus in the Morning radio network adds three new tendrils to its web this week. Radio stations KHTK, Sacramento, California, KQWB, Fargo, North Dakota, and WZNN, Rochester, New Hampshire, all answering the siren song of the quick buck.
Well,
though the 30-odd stations already plugged into Imus know well what the decision brought them, a trade-off of profits for integrity, I feel a sense of duty to warn these latest clients and their audiences of what's in store.
Oh, okay.
It is difficult to identify just what aspect of the Imus program is the most offensive to the largest audience segment, but one must start somewhere.
Good.
Therefore, write down the following numbers. 1-800-272-1957. Now, burn them. The act may mean little to you now, but within a matter of days, you'll be very glad that you at least made this small gesture. That 800 number will become at first familiar to you, and then anathema to you. It's the order number for overpriced items of apparel and the occasional trinkets marketed from El Paso, Texas, by Imus's brother, Fred, a man who you will very quickly associate with the likes of fugitive financier Robert Vesco and snake oil salesman of the Old West.
Yeah.
Prepare to hear that number, along with interminable perorations about this jejune junk, at an average of, oh, say, 500 times an hour. Further, prepare to be subjected then to visits with Fred, mind-numbing conversations between the two Imus brothers, whose principal features are utter banality, punctuated by long lapses of total silence. As I said, I had to start listing these violations of sensibilities somewhere. The order in which I'll relate other items does not in any way relate to their degree of insult.
No.
For example, you will rapidly become anesthetized by the I-Man's pretentious interviews with princes and princesses of Prince,
yeah,
affected darlings of the parlor paint socialist set. The author, Pete Hamill, the columnist, Anna Quinlan, the president, Bill Clinton, most quickly come to mind, though there are innumerable others. Others who you'll be exposed to in the Imus name-dropping decathlon, a special Imus event which names spew forth in a torrent of flash flood ferocity that will cause the listener to feel suffocating. It is not pleasant.
No.
Then there are the gratuitous body part references.
Yeah.
Penis this and penis that.
Yeah.
The unrelenting pup tent in your pants refrain.
Well,
telephone conversations probing the most intimate recesses of unsuspecting callers' private lives.
Yeah.
From so why did you get divorced to have you ever measured your boner? Among other examples of the worst kind of intellectual regression.
Yeah.
And so, welcome, Sacramento, Fargo, Rochester, to what I like to call the simple led by the stupid. Beavis and Butthead dumbed down. Yes, burn 1-800-272-1957. But jot down and f***ing file the number 666. It's loose in your community. For Media Watch and today's special audience alarm, this is Walter Cronkite. Thank you and good night.
William Howard Taft campaigns for the presidency, October 1908.
As the Republican platform says,
the glowing light, look for the stars.
That's right.
Step Friday, get your
book. It's 16 after 8, I'm going to warn you.
Glad he walked across the desert with no shoes. We'll be right back.
Slopes. I stepped on one in 72 and wound up skidding on my ass all the way back to California, if you recall.
Yes, I do.
And this is really starting to smell the same, mind you. What with Mark Garrett, that Paul Begala character, and George Snuffleupagus or whatever.
Yeah.
Slapping Fritz into a stone wall like the Three Stooges trying to hold back the Atlantic. Well, let me just say this. I love it. Inspiring. Gladdens my heart.
Yeah.
In fact, with apologies to this rapper outfit, Saget, I've said a couple of Dick Nixon's Whitewater thoughts to Melody, Dano, if I may. I think you'll like this, J.D.
I'm bad.
It's relevant, dude. Here we go now. Question. Why is it every time somebody asks Bill Clinton what's shaking with Whitewater, he runs off to talk about prescription drugs at an old folks home? Fuck that! Eat another burger, tubbo. Question. Why is it every time somebody asks whether Hillary's law firm slipped the screws to Madison Guarantee and bank regulators and stuff, Bubber says, uh-oh, better call the Imus Show. Fuck that.
Yeah.
Go on Arsenio. Question. Why is it every time somebody asks how Vince Foster got laid out straighter than Walt Disney in a nitrogen bath, Bubba says, did I ever tell you about the AstroTurf in my El Camino? Fuck that. Take a puff at my White Owl. Inhale that. When you've got the New York Times saying that your deposits in the Bank of Public Trust are tapped out, memo to Bubba. Don't take out any magazine subscriptions that run past 1996, if you get my drift.
Well,
of course, they insist that not a shred of evidence exists that could nail them.
Right.
Sure, because it's all been processed at the Rose Law Firm is now being used as nesting material for Chelsea's cat. Or more like nesting material for Stephanopoulos' hamster, now that I think about it. Anyway, harsh assessment on this one-issue world through a Dick's eye, I know. But remember, it is the eye of Dick Nixon, a man who's been there, done that, as the president of the United States.
As I leave you, I want you to know...
A man I've loved dearly. Live from El Paso, Texas, Fred Imus. Good morning, Fred.
You're still not out of that suck-it-up mood, are you?
What are you talking about?
Well, you sucked up to the president and embarrassed me.
How did I embarrass you by sucking up?
Hey, man, I got an idea. I got an event that could be bigger than that Bobby Riggs, Billie Jean King match.
Really?
Yeah. We get any politician, and then we get you and Larry King to see who gets the most butt.
If your radio song's funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning.
Been watching that Discovery Channel lately. I watch some educational channels, you know.
I do.
Had a big show on dinosaurs.
Really?
Yeah. They've been able to prove they had lesbian dinosaurs.
Here we go.
Jesus.
Here we go.
You know what they called it?
No.
Licked a lot of puss.
Jesus Christ. You're a disgusting pig.
Imus in the Morning.
You'd like
Sport Radio 66, WFAN-February.
And good morning, everybody. Russ Salzberg with you here live at the play-by-play over at the Garden on this first day of March 1994. The number for you to call, as always, is 718-937-6666. And while we're here at the Garden today, lots of Garden business to talk. Great, will you? All right, we've got another hour to go here live at the play-by-play. Russ Salzberg with you. Stick around. More.
More coming up. Sonny, that's what's happening. This is John Binko with 2020 Sports on WFAN, the flagship station for New York Knicks basketball.
All righty, Russ Salzberg back with you here on the fan, live at the play-by-play over at Madison Square Garden. And here we go into hour number three. The number is always 718-937-6666. Just in case you missed, the Nets might turn them around. A bad performance, though, might continue them on that downward slide. My thanks today to Rangers GM Neil Smith, Giants GM George Young, American League umpire Steve Palermo, our own Mike Green, Bill Rodman, Dick James here with me live at the play-by-play, Scazzeri back at the ranch, and as always, you the fans. Until tomorrow, it is bye-bye, so long, and farewell.
Here now, on the Imus Morning Program, the President of the United States, Bill Clinton. Good morning, Mr. President.
Good morning, Doug. How are you?
Your cholesterol is around 204, right?
Yeah, I lost 15 pounds, but my cholesterol is still too high.
Yeah, but the other day I read about the Clinton burger and that pastrami sandwich and that apple fritter the size of a baby's head that you'd eaten.
hey, that the apple fritter, I had one bite of a as an apple fritter.
But then,
on the way out. Yeah, that's all right. I did get off my diet that day.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning on the Fan.
A lot of problems in the healthcare system, mostly related to the way we finance it.
One of the ways, Mr. President, you could settle all this is for you and the First Lady to take on Harry and Louise from those insurance company commercials in like a segment of American Gladiators.
Yeah, you know, I wouldn't mind that, actually. I heard about them, I thought they were Thelma and Louise, you know.
WFAN 2020 Sports.
Good afternoon. Minko with 2020 Sports on WFAN, the flagship station for New York Rangers hockey.
Mike and the Mad Dog, Sports Radio 66, WFAN.
Good afternoon, everybody. I am Eagle Bill Daughtry in second day of vacation for Mike and the Mad Dog. Mr. Francesa will be back tomorrow. I have got the power chair today, the big chair. The big kahuna, Mike Francesa's chair, and Billy sitting over on the other side. We switched seats today. Billy sitting in Russo's spot. Chris down in Aruba, Mike in Florida, but Francesa will be back tomorrow. Billy, how you doing?
I'm all right. Another dead spot in sports calendar today, Bert.
No. Absolutely not. Absolutely not.
I don't look anything like Russo.
No, you don't.
Must be the San Diego.
No, it's the stash. I think it's the mustache. Chris can't actually grow facial hair.
Okay,
no, actually, signal him. Come on in. Sure. Nah, I think the I-Man was going to stay out of here. Stay out of here for this particular program. Mike will be back tomorrow, so maybe we'll hear the
I-Man. Maybe he'll come in then.
During the afternoon.
Maybe it'll be Mike and the I-Man tomorrow.
That could happen.
What do you think?
I could see that pairing happening. They get along. 718-937-6666. John in Wayne is on the fan. How are you, John? I don't know exactly what they're going to be able to do.
I think Brown will change his tune if they put some more commas and zeros on that contract.
You might be right about that. There's Michael Haynes, Anthony Miller, Haywood Jeffries. They're out there. It's going to cost a lot of money, though. Minko's next.
Mike and the Mad Dog, Sports Radio 66,
in a subpar performance, and he's struggling a little bit of late.
Like the Oakland A's, you know, back in the day, they used to fight with each other, but all they did was bring back the rings.
More coming up after me
with the Flash of 3 on the Fan.
Mike and the Mad Dog, Sports Radio 66, WFAN.
Good afternoon, Bill Daughtry and Iron Eagle sitting in for Mike and the Mad Dog. Dr. Francesa will return to the power chair sometime tomorrow. No, actually, it'll be at about 1 o'clock. Chris is on vacation somewhere where the sun is shining and they don't talk about American sports. Good for him. Meanwhile, we are with you until 6. It's 718-937-6666. You know, Iron, I got
the Yukon Huskies, 15. 13-2 in the conference. They've already wrapped up the division title. 25-3 overall. Currently ranked number 4 in the nation. They got one first place vote, I'm sure, from somebody in the Connecticut area. They're going to be a number 1 seed if they continue along these lines. Minko is next for the update. But he admits to that.
Yeah.
And we'll talk about that with Buck Showalter a little bit later on. That'll be after Minko, after Corey Hirsch on the Fan of New York. Jim Calhoun, Steve Jones, Corey Hirsch, Buck Showalter, Rob Tepper,
and you,
Dove Kramer, Billy Daughtry, Ian Eagle. Stay tuned. Howie Rowe is next after the John Clossy update.
Temperature 32 degrees. That's what's happening. I'm John Clossy with 2020 Sports on WFAN, the flagship station for New York Knicks basketball.
What do you say? Howie Rose with you on the FanDuel 7:40 tonight as we take you first to the St. John's Boston College game, and then the Knicks and the Sacramento Kings out at the Arco Arena in Sacramento. Well, welcome back, John Clossy. Is he the voice of doom or what? Guy comes in here and he's got another stinking snowstorm on the way. Snowstorm, rainstorm. I guess it depends who you watch or listen to. Nobody seems to be able to get the story straight. Some say this thing is going to pile up to about 12 inches of snow. Others say a little bit of snow, a lot of rain. I think the safest thing to do is just book a trip to Florida and get the hell out of here already, because this is getting aggravating.
It's 718-706-7690. That's 718-706-7690. The Sitch Radiothon on Sports Radio 66 WFAN, New York. Dr. Samuel Sitch.
Six, Howie Rose here. From what I've seen,
and you know, maybe Maley's had a little bit of an impact here too,
they seem to be getting a lot more pressure and playing with the grit and tenacity that Al Arbor teams are noted for. And you know what? Even throw out what happens this weekend against the Rangers, because they're just always a different team against the Rangers. We'll talk about that with Jay Wells next.
Pardon me? He was delightful.
Well, he was delightful.
He was terrific, Senator.
Well, he was pretty good, actually, didn't you think?
Yes, he was.
He needs a dress. We'll send him a shirt. All right. All right, here now, representing the great state of Connecticut, Senator Joseph Lieberman. Good morning, Senator Lieberman.
Hey, first of all, do you know where Michael Jackson is? I think he's in Southport, Connecticut.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the morning.
Let me ask you just a couple of questions about that mess in New Jersey, and not necessarily about that particularly, but yeah. When you were running in Connecticut, how did you handle keeping the vote down in various areas when you ran?
I came on your show.
Imus in the morning.
Area, 27 degrees. And that's what's happening. I'm Bill Daughtry with 2020 Sports, WFAN, the radio home of the Birdman, Iron Eagle, and the flagship station for New York Rangers hockey.
On the Fan. Good evening, everybody. Iron Eagle taking you until 7 o'clock. And then we hand you over to Howie Rose. Sal Messina standing by at Madison Square Garden. It'll be the Rangers and the Quebec Nordiques. This game, the one being made up for the one that was missed because of the poor weather. And I think we're starting to see a trend here with the Rangers and the Nordiques here in New York. Every time the two teams are matched up, there's a snowstorm.
guy with the glasses says hello, and we'll talk to you later.
Hi, Ian. How you doing?
Oh, sure, Sal. Now you want to be my buddy, right?
Hey, Sal.
You don't know me from a hole in the wall.
He said six times he's met you, and each time you didn't know who he was, I said, well, Ian, maybe he couldn't find you.
Very good. But good luck,
Howie.
All right. Well, listen to you on the radio, guys. Rangers Quebec coming up. Bill Daughtry, the update. Ian Eagle, we'll talk to you after the game. Enjoy it. Sports Radio.
Now, live from El Paso, Texas, my brother, Fred Imus. Good morning, Fred. Hey, Paul Begala wants a work shirt.
Okay, I can't, you know, I got people backed up. I got orders backed up, so I can't do it for just a little bit.
Yeah, let him wait. Yeah.
We have to go and order on these because...
Don't wait too long. They may not be there very much.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning on The Fan.
Kathleen Sullivan is here. We already like her attitude.
Yeah.
She has a great attitude. Sure.
So why is age important with, as far as relationships?
Why is it important to me?
Yeah.
You know, I don't want to hold somebody on my shoulders for 3 hours at a program. I'm just not into that.
Now, 12 years from now, she's what, 41, right?
Yeah.
I mean, she's putting you in a home.
Or in a home.
Preferably.
WFAN 2020 Sports.
It's 7 o'clock. I'm Bill Daughtry.
Radio Network. As we drag our sorry butts through year number 2 of the illegal occupation of the capital of the country by Yuri the Hun. And yet, wait, what's that I see breaching the horizon? Ah, yes, a great sign in the sky that reads, "Attention, hostage citizens of America, only 2 more Black History Months until Hillary and her goober consort are themselves history." Let's take some calls.
Oh, good.
Why not White History Month, my ultra-sensitive liberal robot pals, eh? Ooh, no. That might risk offending some bow-tie-wearing motor-mouth moron who wants me to pay him 400 gazillion food stamps because Kunta Kinte had to pick a little cotton in the Delta a million years ago.
That'll be fine.
Mega forget about it, Mustafa. Yes, it is I, my right-thinking toadies who gush over Rush. Rush Limbaugh, standing before you as a bulwark against truth decay. The periodontal attack on institutions we hold so dear. The state flag of Georgia. The old South. And the new North, Ollie. Somebody give me a few mega dittos on a true American hero. Thank you. And lest we forget, our latest national hero, the Islam sect freak, Khalid Wildman Muhammad, who speaks for our crowd gang as he disparages Jews and the papal cracker mackerel snapper on the throne in Rome.
That will be enough.
Question, ladies and gentlemen, is the Pope a cross-dresser? Get it?
Yeah.
Cross-dresser?
Yeah,
more megadiddles to... All right, let's just flip for a moment through the Washington... Gotta hurry because my parakeets need to relieve themselves. Let's see. What are the communist pinko whining hantaviruses up to today? Oh, my. What's this? Headline, Whitewater may sink bill in 96. Terrible! What's wrong with 94? And look at this, the Arkansas scandal du jour, folks. Bubba's golfing buddy, another Clintonista out of the celebrated Rose Law Firm and now Associate Attorney General Webster Hubbell, is being investigated?
No way.
No way! And for overbilling clients and using Rose Law Firm money to pay for personal stuff? Goodness gracious me! In the words of the bard, would a law firm by any other name El Stinko the same? Let me answer that one for you. Probably. Yeah. They're doing a terrific job of reinventing government, aren't they? Bubba Clinton, the first president to turn the White House into the Big House before their reinvention is through. Wonderful. And all Nancy ever did was order a couple of place settings of dishes. Where's justice, ladies and gentlemen? I cry out in anguish. Ah, screw it. Anyway, final item. Attention, Farrakhan watch. In the words of a recent dribbling liberal thumbsuck think piece, just what is it that divides blacks and Jews? Permit me to propose a theory. Ribs. You can't live with them, you can't live without them. And also wine, of course, on opposite sides of that great divide between our Afro-Americans and Hebrew-Americans. To it, is it Mogan David with baby backs or Muscatel with matzahs? I could never figure it out. Attention, Jeff Gilolian gang. Next time with Nancy, right in the chop. More after this.
Rush Limbaugh on the Imus in the Morning program, coming to you live from New York City.
This is every time she does a report, she can't do it on time.
I hear now the executive assistant to the Imus at a Morning program, Liesl Denton, on her car phone, probably calling to see if we want anything. She's on her way into
bagels,
the
coffee.
Sure, that sort of
good
sure.
Morning.
Good morning, Liesl.
Morning.
Flashback. All right, here now with comment and observation on headline issues of the day, Imus in Washington senior political analyst Richard M. Nixon.
Hi, man. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you so much as always. How's the lunch?
Well,
and who cares? Very appreciative of this opportunity to share with you some of my latest reflections.
Sure.
Of course, the burning issue of the day needs no introduction by me, demanding as it is of the whole world's undivided attention.
Right.
So let me turn at once to issue one to take a close-up look at the far-reaching effects of Madonna's girly show. Or, as it's been observed, Madonna, what else can she show us?
Yeah.
Oh, there it is. Again, for God's sakes. And let's review for just a moment.
Right.
She's shown us her...
Right.
She's shown us her...
Right.
She's shown us her poop shoot.
Right.
We've seen her in every stage of coupling with everything and everybody from an unnamed eunuch to a Cuisinart. And now this bimbo, desperately seeking career revival, offers us the Madonna girly tour. Due to New York in just a matter of days.
Right.
Well, look, I like a good lap dance as well as the next fellow, but here's a memo to Madonna. You're a darling child. However, unless your show includes putting slides of your most recent gynecological exam on overhead projection, it's over. We have seen everything, okay? Put your clothes on and get out. Now then, issue two, right. Speaking of get out, the Paul Simon Show with Art Garfunkel, or I'm Okay, You Suck. Now, were I Paul staging this blockbuster new show, I believe I just recognize that it's time to cut my losses and jettison once and for all that goofball sidekick who never could sing, for crying out loud, and who looks like, I don't know, like you ought to be showing you a camera at 47th Street Photo or something. Believe me, the New York Times was beyond gracious in saying that Garfunkel's voice now seems frayed and earthbound.
Yeah.
I went to the opening show, I imagine, and what it sounds like is pulling a leaf rake over your neck. Art, I hate to be unkind, but you're pathetic. Get out.
Fine.
Issue three. Turning to the political arena as we conclude here today, Commerce Secretary Ron Brown, or in the words of the old country ballad, if you've got the money, honey, I've got the time. This guy's clean, hey, I man?
Well,
right. They've got to be measuring his head for the proverbial raincoat right now and getting that other fashion accessory ready as well, the adjustable bracelets that are hooked together.
What?
I believe they're referred to as handcuffs in some circles. You know, you were really way out in front of the curve on this one, J.D. So anyway, we learned that not only has Secretary Brown been helping Bill Clinton reinvent America's government, he's also helping Vietnam reinvent theirs.
Yeah.
And just let Dick Nixon say, what a selfless gesture.
Yeah.
So now the story is that he has some Haitian babe with ties.
place of the old Duvalier dictatorship, illegally stashed in a $360,000 Washington, D.C. townhouse,
right,
fluttering her baby blues at the former deputy premier of Vietnam,
right,
who just happens to be a fat cat who might be able to plug old Ron into undeveloped, hot-to-trot Southeast Asian oil reserves. And we're supposed to buy that nothing was going on?
Well,
oh, yeah. And Marlene Cook and the Lone Ranger riding the hood of her car the other night were just returning from a baby shower. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Pardon me, Bobby Vesco, but I don't think so.
Yeah.
Of course, what I really want to know is this babe's beeper number. Come on, Chickie. We can do business. I know how the process works. It can be you, me, and a super tanker or two of that hot Hanoi crew. And that's the world through a Dick's eye. That of Dick Nixon, a former major player, I'd remind you, but he was the president of the United States.
Imus in the morning, 2020 sports.
Oh, wheels are coming off the lethal Benton bandwagon. And my new assistant now is making almost a mistake a day.
The nightmare begins for the I-Man's assistant.
Over at Mount Sinai Hospital.
See, Charles has these migraine headaches, but let me tell you what.
And when he gets them,
yeah,
his wife had a serious medical situation.
Mm-hmm. Breast implants.
And Dr.
I don't know why you just don't die. I want you to die. Really, I want you to die.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the morning.
The one thing that you do that is really terrific,
oh,
you constantly apologize. Now, you have a lot to apologize for. I mean, first you get everyone upset.
I don't have a lot to apologize for.
Right.
I have... Well, go ahead.
Well, no, we had a session here on air.
It's about 29 after the hour. It would be 7 here in New York and in K-Big in Denver. I don't know what it is, but Breen was just out there.
Hey, Beavis, your two girlfriends are on CNBC again. Mary Madlick and Jane Walrus.
I like her. She laughs like me.
How did these two chicks get their own TV show?
They suck. They do not. They're cool. Shut up, or I'll have to kick your ass.
Why is Imus sucking up to them?
Because he admires their natural beauty, rapier-like wit, and thoughtful insight.
Yeah, right. He just wants to bone the one whose husband knows the president.
Which one is that?
You know, the dude with the human head and the dog's body.
Yeah. That Cajun dude. He's cool.
If I had a human head and a dog's body, that would be so cool.
Yeah. You could, like, pee on fire hydrants and stuff.
Yeah, and lick myself.
Yeah. And every time the president brought chicks into the White House, you could, like, hump their legs.
Yeah.
I'm a city morning.
Hey, butthead, check it out. The Grammy Awards.
This is, like, the show that, like, you think is going to be cool, but, like, it sucks.
Except when Bono said,
yeah, that was cool.
I bet you Bobby Brown is saying it a lot, too.
Yeah, Whitney Houston wins another award, and he might, like, kill himself.
If I hear that song one more time, I might, like, kill myself. I will always love you.
She sucks.
Yeah, but Steven Tyler is cool.
Even though he's, like, 60 and looks like a spider monkey.
Check it out. Meatloaf. He'd, like, do anything for love, except, like, lose weight.
You flemois, that's not Meatloaf. It's that little fat chick in the bee costume from the Blind Melon video.
For a minute, I thought it could have been that bowling ball on Aaron Neville's forehead.
That thing is cool. It looks like somebody, like, took a dump on his eye.
Hey, where's Rod Stewart?
I think he's on CNBC with those two political chicks.
That's not Rod Stewart. That's, like, Rod Stewart's father.
Delbert McClinton will be at Wolf Trap tonight in Vienna, Virginia. And here the boy is.
Fred Imus. Good morning, Fred.
Hey, Paul Begala wants a work shirt.
Okay, Captain. You know, I got people backed up. I got orders backed up, so I can't do it for just a little bit.
Yeah, let him wait.
We have to go and order on these because...
Don't wait too long. They may not be there very much.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the morning.
Kathleen Sullivan is here. We already like her attitude.
Yeah.
Great attitude, sure.
Now, why is age important as far as relationships?
Why is it important to me?
Yeah.
You know, I don't want to hold somebody on my shoulder for 3 hours at a program concert. I'm just not into that.
Now, 12 years from now, she's what, 41, right?
Yeah.
I mean, she's putting you in a home.
Or in a home. Preferably. 7:48 now, New York.
Sports Radio 66, WFAN.
The next governor of California, Kathleen Brown. Coming up.
Imus in the morning.
A year ago.
Yeah.
How we doing? Are getting the t-shirts out?
We're doing great.
And how about people who ordered coffee mugs? Are they all going to get them?
We got a little problem with some of the coffee mugs.
I just love it.
You're a thief. That's what you are.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the morning.
Yeah, there's laws to prevent you, but this is interstate commerce. I mean,
sure.
This is a federal offense.
Why don't you bend over? I'll give you some interstate commerce.
Yeah.
I'll drive you across the state line.
Imus in the morning.
Your two girlfriends are on.
Roger, Glenn. Good morning, Roger.
Hey, man.
What?
You read about these people coming into hospital emergency rooms and their bodies and giving off them fumes, making everybody dizzy?
Roger, don't you have something better to do than... Huh?
Talk about a natural high.
Well, oh, God. God.
Man, why can't I have D.O. like that?
I don't know.
Not only would I be in a perpetual buzz 24 hours a day, I could sell whiffs of my pits at like $20 a pop.
That'll be fine.
Hey, you want some inside White House dirt?
Oh, yeah, okay.
I better do this in code. D.D. Myers, eyebrows, hair club for men. They're stick-ons, man. You just knew that face wasn't real, didn't you?
Well,
she keeps him in a glass of water on her nightstand when she goes to bed at night, man.
Let's not be disparaging D.D. Myers.
Looks like she's drowned in a couple of woolly bear caterpillars.
Well,
what am I saying? Looks like a pair of caterpillar tractors at the bottom of the lake. Hey, I hear you say you're going ring shopping for your lady, man.
Well, yeah.
Don't go getting yourself one now. Because when the women put one of them rings on your finger, they put another imaginary one in your nose.
I don't think so.
That was the out cue, by the way. I just realized that. You wouldn't know, of course. No big yuck there. What do you think's up with him?
Is he gone?
Now, are you gone, Roger?
Did Roger hang
up? Or are
you
still there?
He may have just passed out or something.
He's on drugs. Roger.
Come on. I'm
Imus in the morning news time coming about 8 minutes after 9 o'clock tomorrow. The governor of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, William Weld. Brooklyn Bridge. Is that right, Eileen? He's still up there?
Yes, he is.
He's a black guy, about 250 pounds.
Well, should be climbed in by a state building.
With, shut you know. Jesus Christ.
Oh, you're just an idiot.
Look at the world talent.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the morning.
Is Nancy here yet?
She's here, yeah.
She's here.
You have her bring me a half a glass of water, please.
Get off the building.
That should have been her.
She put her sign down, yeah.
Oh, I forgot to reveal that the 250-pound African-American climbing the Brooklyn Bridge was my secretary.
Imus in the morning.
Highway Patrol.
If you're in,
with a guns and a lone star beard, talking religion and a politics for all the world to hear. They ought to send you back to Russia, boy, or New York City one. You just want to doodle a Christian girl and you kill God's only son.
Imus in the morning.
It's time for sports. Imus in the morning. 2020 sports.
Here's Anderson at the line. Now to Gartner on right wing. Over the line. He dropped for Messier. In front of Anderson. He's all alone. He backhands. And he scores! And that's a shorthanded goal.
And the Rangers win again. Good morning. This is Mike Breen with Sports.
Morning, Joseph. Let me explain something to you and Lou. Bernard and Lou. You listening to me?
No.
Who?
I'm being serious here.
Listen.
We're starting to get off track here. Your role is not to answer the listeners. You understand me?
I just
Your role is to provide little witty observations, you know, at appropriate points.
Man, fuck that. Get out of my face. You know what I'm saying?
Are you two going to participate in this program today?
Well, no, but you know what? But don't. I mean, you know, sometimes Charles does that, too. I mean, you know, you have to talk when I... Don't talk when I'm talking.
Well, then shut up for a while.
I don't need that. Fuck that.
I'll just wait till you're dead, then I'll start talking. How's that?
You're going to be dead at 10 o'clock, you little bastard. How does that sound? Let's get this thing back on track here. Something to irritate time, man. We don't need that.
Ernie and Lou told me you mellowed since I've been gone. You're right.
Well, get this thing off the rails here. It's like that Continental Airlines jet out there hanging half in the water. We don't need that. All right, let's start this sports thing all over here.
All right.
Now, here we go. Good. Take one. God.
Yeah, right.
Here we go.
Imus in the morning. 2020 sports.
Here's Anderson at the Ranger line, to the red line. Now to Kortner on right wing. Over the line. He drops for Messier. In front of Anderson. He's all alone. He's back in. And he scores! And that's a shorthanded goal.
And the Rangers win again. Good morning. This is Mike Breen with sports. Howie Rose with the call on WFAN in New York.
Let's
But enough
stop
about hockey.
Here. Let's just stop here.
Right.
We hate hockey.
What did I just say? But enough about hockey.
Well, yeah, but I mean, why even bother to lead with it?
Because you forced me to play these play-by-play calls.
No, I don't.
All right. But we won't play them anymore.
We've never had a discussion about it, have we?
Yes, we have. Of course we have.
Did we really?
I don't do anything on my own.
Yes, you do. When did we have a discussion about it?
Months ago, when we did this 2020 sports deal.
What did I say?
You said you always wanted me to come out of it with some form of play-by-play, not my own voice, but some form of play-by-play.
Did I say that?
Yes, you did.
Yeah. Did I?
I believe I do recall a conversation along those lines. I
bet. Oh, we're rescinding that now.
Great.
You said that if you forgot, you'd give Bernie a $500 bill.
I didn't say that. That was the program director who wanted that.
All right.
But, I mean, we don't want hockey.